Well, so I'm a general public international lawyer. I got my start working at the State Department in the legal office. So I have focused on a whole variety of different international law issues, including human rights. But my main focus for the last 20 years has been international environmental law, and then within international environmental law, climate change law. So I focus really on how do you develop international institutions and international agreements to try to get countries to cooperate to address the climate change problem.
Dan's contribution to his field is to be a lawyer scholar. He is practical enough that he can make useful suggestions for policymakers, and he's theoretical enough that he can step back above what other people see at the ground level to suggest architectural changes that might end up affecting the way in which particular provisions are written. It requires you to see close up and far at a distance at the same time. Not everybody has that gift to have both theory and practice at the same time.
I would hope my legacy is to help people think more clearly about how international environmental law works, to have a better understanding of how it works. A lot of what I do, I think, is translating complex ideas to an audience that's a broader audience. The book I wrote that I'm most proud of, The Art and Craft of International Environmental Law, is written for a wide audience, not just for specialists. But I sort of have two sides to my work. One is a very practical side that's focused on the negotiations and how do you get an agreement that's more effective in addressing the climate change problem. But then I also am quite interested in theoretical issues. So I think probably the work I'm most proud of is the work I've done on the legitimacy of international laws.
I know it's a bit of a pun, but I would say that Dan's work is truly earth-changing. This is his life's work, is really being the lead person in the United States and around the world on global climate change and the legal and regulatory responses to that. And I think what really makes him stand out among a whole great number of legal academics is how much his work affects the world outside of the academy. He has been an individual who's worked at the White House under the Clinton administration. He has led U.S. efforts to negotiate the Paris climate change agreements and other international agreements relating to climate change. He still supervises and helps out different countries. He was advising the Swiss government on their responses to the Paris climate change agreement. So he really is just an earth-changing scholar and advisor to governments, and we're incredibly proud to have him.